Hi, my name is Roxana Mirza. I'm a professor of ophthalmology and a medical retina specialist in Chicago.
And I'm Nora Ladd, and I work as a medical retina specialist and associate professor in a large academic practice in North Carolina. We're very excited to be here today to tell you about our field. After ophthalmology residency, medical retina is generally a one-year fellowship that focuses on diseases of the retina, including macular degeneration, retinal vascular occlusions, diabetic retinopathy, inherited retinal diseases, malignancies, and inflammatory infectious conditions of the retina. Medical retina training focuses on in-office procedures such as intravitreal injections and lasers. Fellows also learn and are involved in the preoperative and postoperative course of diseases that require surgery, such as retinal detachments. Roxana, what made you choose ophthalmology and why medical retina?
I was drawn to ophthalmology in my third year of medical school. After I did my medicine and my surgery clerkships, I realized what I liked about both of them. In medicine, I loved the thoroughness and the diagnostic aspect and the continuity of that doctors had with their patients. And in surgery, I loved the fast pace and the interventional nature of the day. I really fell into groove when I did my ophthalmology clerkship, and I realized that I could have all of these things in one field. As far as medical retina, at the end of my residency training, the reports about anti-VEGF were coming out, and this was going to be a game changer in our field. Diseases previously that were considered to be just vision loss, blinding diseases, were now going to be able to be treated in the office. Furthermore, there was exciting innovation around imaging that was really advancing the knowledge about retinal diseases, and the field really just was exploding. How about you, Nora? What made you choose medical retina and ophthalmology?
My initial pathway is a bit different. I did a doctoral training in neuroscience, and I studied neurodegenerative diseases and experimental therapy, such as neurotransplantation, stem cells, and delivery neurotrophic factors. It was at that time when I realized that retinal degenerative diseases and neurodegenerative diseases share numerous pathways, yet they're all currently without cures. It was initially from this research perspective that I chose ophthalmology as a medical specialty and later medical retina. My career goal became to translate my basic science research into contributing to an understanding of the pathobiology of macular degeneration and other retinal degenerative conditions and assist in development of novel targeted treatment approaches. But as I learned more about the clinical aspects of ophthalmology and medical retina, I love them and love the ability to restore vision through individualized procedures.
So what does a typical day look like for you?
I currently spend about 50% of my time seeing medical retina patients and 50% in research activities, both translational and clinical. My research days are spent seeing clinical trial study patients in the laboratory, in person or virtual conferences, or at the reading center. Family is also important for me and a large part of my day in the evenings. We have three kids and a puppy. I believe that self-care is critical to maintain the focus. And while I'm extremely passionate about my career and helping patients every day, I learned that I'm truly at my best when I take time to exercise, stay healthy. It's also important to enjoy family, vacation time, activities, and hobbies. What do you like best about your work?
I enjoy the incredible diversity of each day. My time in clinic is busy. Retina specialists see a lot of patients, and that's because the diseases we treat are so prevalent. I really enjoy teaching medical students, residents, and fellows. And medical retina really provides a lifestyle that you can also focus on other academic areas that interest you and be very impactful in those areas. Furthermore, I love learning, and there are so many advances in technology and treatments that every retina conference is so exciting, and it's really a vibrant community of colleagues. But most of all, it's the patients. I have the privilege of taking care of a lot of older patients, and vision is a huge part of independence as individuals age. It's also a big part of connection with others. I can recall one individual very fondly. He had lost one eye to advanced macular degeneration prior to the anti-VEGF era, and he was receiving injections by me in the other eye. Unfortunately, he received advanced cancer diagnosis, and he chose not to pursue any treatment for that, but did continue on seeing me. One day I received a call from his wife, who was very grateful. He passed away on his 90th birthday and surrounded by his family, and she was very grateful that he could see them when he passed away. And so it really just puts all of it into perspective and has really been impactful to me.
This is a very touching story. Thank you so much for sharing it with us.
Well, as you can see, There are a lot of great fields within ophthalmology, and you really can find almost any kind of niche that you can imagine. We hope that you'll consider ophthalmology and medical retina. Medical retina specifically is endless with possibilities, and it's very ripe for new technologies such as artificial intelligence, telehealth, and exciting advances in gene therapy. Thanks so much for being here with us today.
Thank you.